We're going to solve Project Euler problem 32.3. The problem is the following one. If we take a look at the fractions, then we can see that certain of these fractions are curious because if we attempt to simplify them by cancelling the digit-wise, for example here cancelling this 9 for this 9, it actually gives us the correct result of 4/8. Of course, this technique for cancelling fractions is not correct, but sometimes it works. We need to find every fraction which has two digits in its numerator and in its denominator that for which this incorrect technique of simplifying works. Fractions like these ones right here are trivial and we won't consider them. We need to find the denominator of the product of the of these four fractions. So let's start out by generating all the fractions that are that have two digits in their numerator and in their denominator. So we can do this. I will just do it in the main function right here. So this main function is a work in progress. We will finish it later off, but first of all, let's do all the fractions that we need to consider. So fractions can be represented as a tuple A and B, where A is the numerator and B is the denominator. We only need to consider the fractions that are less than 1 in value. So we can choose the denominator between 10 and 99. But the numerator, of course, needs to be less than the denominator because the fraction needs to be less than 1. So we can choose the numerator in the range 10 up to b minus 1. Alright. Now, of course, we need to filter them if they are curious or not. Little typo right there, and we need to define this curious to find out if a fraction has this property that incorrect simplifying works. So the predicate is curious takes a pair of integer and integer, and it gives us back a bool value. So is curious will be finished later. Of first of all, we need to define a function that simplifies a fraction. So simplify takes a fraction and returns a fraction, the simplified version of it. Simplify is implemented rather easily. If we have a fraction A and B, then we need to find out the greatest common divisor. So let divisor equal the greatest common divisor of A and B, which GCD, of course, is a built-in function into Haskell. We don't need to define it. And we can then cancel the fraction by dividing the numerator by this divisor and the denominator by this divisor. Now, a fraction is curious, so let's have the argument a fraction. We call the fraction as a whole x, and the numerator is a, and the denominator is b. So, well, of course, we need to find out the individual digits of the numerator and the denominator. So, let's do this just here. We have the first digit in the numerator, which I call n1 and d1, and n2 as the second digit of the denominator. We can find these ones out by calculating, well, numerator divisor and modulo of to 10, because a divided by 10 will give us the first digit of the numerator, and a modulo 10 will give us the second digit of the numerator. We can do the same for the denominator, so we have d1 and d2. which is b div mod 10. Now a fraction is curious. Well, if we can cancel it digit wise, so that is if the first digit of the denominator is equal to the second digit of the denominator. We don't consider the case when the first digit of the denominator is equal to the first digit of the denominator, because that would be a trivial case. And if we can simplify the fraction, and we actually get the same result as if we simplify the fraction in which we have n1 cancelled out with d2. So if the remaining digit in the denominator, which is d2, and d1, which is the remaining digit in the denominator, are a fraction that is equal to x. We need to simplify it, because that's how we can determine if they are truly equal in value. Of course, it could also be the case that it is the other way around, that n2 is equal to d1, and simplifying x yields the same as simplifying, well, the remaining digit, which in that case is n1 and d2. So well, that's our iscurious function. Now back to the main function. We now have a list of the curious fractions, and we need to build the product of them. So the way we can do this is, actually, let's just I will write down what the types of this. So here we have a list of tuples, and now if we apply the unzip function, we get a tuple of lists. And of course, these are the nominators and these are the denominators. So if we do that, we can just, well, take the product of this, take the product of this, and then afterwards simplify it. So we have the total products of curious fractions, sorry, the total product of curious fractions, of which we can then take the denominator. So the way we can calculate the product of this and this in one step is by applying the bimap function. This will apply two functions onto these two values right here. So in both cases we want a product. So I write product. Of course, bimap is in the package, or sorry, in the module data dot byte bifunctor. And well, now we have the product of the curious fractions. Now we need to simplify it, because that's, well, that's the task in the project Euler's problem statement. And now we can just print it out. So let's compile it. And run it with time. And as you see, the fraction that we get is 100. And the correct answer, of course, is the denominator, which is 100. Oh well, and the solution is quite fast, as you can see. So, thanks for watching.